Milind, this they, I mean, Shiv had presented this concept called OEE, right? Something.
Yeah.
Effective. Can you?
Equipment. Overall equipment effectiveness, I think.
Overall equipment. Okay. Yeah. Overall equipment effectiveness.
Hmm.
How well the equipment is doing overall. Okay. Something like that. Now, there, so it's a product of three something. I mean, can you pull up the slide? I mean, I just,
yeah, let's maybe it's a little complicated, the formula.
So this is what it has three factors. These are factors, right? Three factors.
These are three factors, yes.
The product of three factors. The first, and all of them are written in percentage terms. So it, eventually you'll get a percentage. So the first one is availability. It says, you have planned for some number of hours, you lost some hours. So you subtract the number of lost hours. So basically you're trying to compute how many hours you lost or did not lose, how many hours you did not lose out of the total planned hours, right? Now in our data set, there is only one way to lose an hour or lose a shift actually. You can only lose shift.
Look at the data. So we'll go back to this gear 6A data.
So changeover and maintenance are assumed to be planned, I guess.
Yes, I would think so. Okay.
So the only thing that is unplanned is that breakdown maintenance. What is marked there under? Otherwise, everything is planned.
Yes.
Correct, na?
Correct.
So
if you look at this, planned production hours minus lost time.
And since we don't have hours, we only have shifts. We can count shifts. Doesn't matter, right? So we can say number of shifts planned minus number of shifts lost.
One shift is 8 hours.
One shift is eight hours, 12 hours. I don't know. Okay, eight hours.
Let's just say 8 hours.
But we don't. It doesn't matter. The 8 will get cancelled because numerator denominator.
Correct.
So you can just count number of shifts, I presume, right? So we can say number of shifts planned minus number of shifts lost divided by number of shifts planned. That should do the job.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Then,
and the only thing you can lose is really this breakdown maintenance, I guess.
Planned, okay. Right. So you can say number of shifts planned minus number of shifts with breakdown maintenance divided by number of shifts planned. But when you're doing number of shifts planned,
No. So now I have an interesting question. Okay. So
I thought maybe I also have the same question.
For hobby, we can say that we lost a shift because of breakdown maintenance.
Yeah.
For broaching, actually, the machine was available in shift 2. But we produced 0.
Oh.
No?
You counted or not?
We produced 0 because in the previous shift, hobbing, we had not produced anything.
So that also you should say that it's lost shift, no? It's lost only.
I suspect, Jivi, that they would not count this as lost equipment hour. They will count it
as the next factor. Oh, I see. Let's go back to that PPT. I think, yeah. That's what they will do. They will count it as a loss in production. Next one is performance.
Yes.
That will be 0 in the denominator and denominator. That's what will happen.
And my guess, okay, why they would do it like this, and this is just my hypothesis, we should check with Shiv, is I think availability is the responsibility of the maintenance crew.
Yeah.
Performance is the responsibility of the people who are working on the shift. Right? So if the machine breaks down, then typically you would say that it has broken down because we didn't do preventive maintenance. Possibly.
Yeah.
Hmm?
Yeah. I guess so. I agree. So again, now I have, even for the availability, I have a question. Should we include the, just go back to that thing, that Excel, minus number of breakdown shifts divided by number of shifts planned, isn't it?
Correct.
So when we say shifts planned, do you include changeover and maintenance in that shift plan, or we don't include that? We should not, no?
I think we don't.
We should not.
Is my opinion. But we should check which.
I agree. Yeah, we should not. So we should say number of shifts planned, which basically does not include changeover maintenance, minus breakdown maintenance divided by number of shifts planned. Okay. I think that first part is very clear. What is the second one? The performance. Performance is how much you produce divided by how much you plan. Right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So 393 by for hobbing, 393 by 388 by 400 in shift 2.
388 by 400. Yes.
Yeah.
For that shift.
For so shift actually, 2 of 110. Yeah.
We should look at it as the sum of. Let's do it weekly.
So let it be done for week one, and then week two is gone anyway. Week one and three, 2 weeks.
Yes.
So weekly, you take the sum of all the things that have been produced, divided by the sum of things planned to be produced.
Correct.
That tells you.
That will tell you performance.
Performance, and this you'll do at the output of broaching, because we don't want to do efficiency by machine. Efficiency overall.
Yes.
So you take the output of broaching sum for 1 week, divided by planned output of broaching for 1 week.
Yes.
Something like that.
Correct.
Correct, na? Something like that.
Correct.
That will be performance. Okay.
Yes.
That's performance.
And the final one is quality.
What is quality? Oh, scrap.
Quality. Scrap.
Yeah. So, amount of product. Oh, but then what are we saying? No. Oh, so.
So.
No. See, so, we did wrong thing.
I got it. So, if you look at broaching, in theory, this machine can work on 400 units in one shift.
Yeah.
Okay. But because the input is only going to give it 390, in a shift, the maximum it can produce is whatever is the input that it got from the previous stage.
Right.
So, in even theoretically, the maximum machine speed that it can have in shift in this shift is 390 divided by 400.
So 390 by 400 is the performance.
Is the performance.
And 383 divided by 390 is the?
The quality.
Quality. Oh, that's how one has to disaggregate. What we did earlier was a product of two things. You should disaggregate.
Correct.
390 by 400 is production, is the performance, and 383 by 390 is the quality. Understand? Okay.
Yes.
So I think and we should give it to students.
It will be 383 by 400.
Understand? Yeah. So let them do this. I think as an exercise, we should leave it.
Hmm.
They can do the weekly for week one and week three. Let them calculate the parameters. What are the three parameters? They have to calculate the
availability,
performance, and quality.
Quality.
These and multiply the three and give us the overall equipment effectiveness. And that let them do it week one and then do it again.
It's very difficult to reach 100%,
GV. It's nearly impossible to reach 100%.
Uh-huh. Seems very difficult.
Yeah. You have to have
so many things can go wrong.
You should run it at full speed and you should know defects. Impossible, not possible.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So, you know, actually, if you have 90% availability, 90% performance, 90% quality, 0.9 into 0.9, 0.9 to 0.9 is 0.81 multiplied by 0.9 is some 0.72 or something.
0.7, 72%, 73% is the what you will get.
That is assuming that each of them is running at 90%.
Correct.
You want to get it at, if you want to get it above 90% overall. You run each of them at 95, 98, 99% something.
Yes.
Quite tough. Yes. All right. Excellent. I think this is good.
Quality, we may be able to drive at maybe 97.5% because Shiv did mention that scrap was 2.5%, right? So, but I don't know if the rest of it we can drive at that.
Availability is 0-1, right? Either you have breakdown or you don't have breakdown. You don't have breakdown 100%.
Correct.
If you have breakdown, one shift is gone. You have only 6 into 12 shifts in a week. One shift is gone means that is straight away 8%.
Yes.
Yeah. Availability is hit and go, something.
It's correct. Like,
you don't know. You might get it or not. Performance, other than it, is a function of how well the guys are doing on that shift. Okay, I think this is good. This is, let them do this exercise, right? Let them find out availability, performance, and quality for week 1 and week 3 for the data given. Okay.
Okay.